Hey guys, welcome. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. I know you're going to be blessed by it. It truly blessed my life and I hope it blesses yours. And I hope that you're able to receive everything that you're looking for. Enjoy this message.
So I want you to tell your neighbor, repentance is a gift.
Dile arrepentimiento es un regalo a tu vecino.
Why is repentance a gift? Repentance is a gift we were given because of the work of the cross.
Es un regalo que nos fue dado por la obra de la cruz.
How many of you here tonight know that Jesus died on a cross for you and I?
¿Cuántos saben que Jesús murió en la cruz por ti y por mí?
Pretty straightforward, it's nothing crazy.
Bien al punto, no es una locura.
But we need to understand, in order to access what God has done for us.
Tenemos que saber para accesar lo que Dios hizo por nosotros.
If I were to start unpacking what the cross has done for you and I,
si yo les muestro que la cruz ha hecho para ti, para mí,
we would be here for the next like 10 years.
Estuviéramos aquí como por 10 años.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amen a eso?
Why? Because there's so much that God, that Jesus did on the cross for us.
¿Por qué? Porque hay tanto que Cristo hizo en la cruz por nosotros.
Repentance is the gift we were given because of the work of the cross.
Fue el arrepentimiento un regalo de la obra en la cruz.
Why is it such a big deal?
¿Por qué es tan gran cosa?
And why is repentance a gift?
¿Y por qué es un regalo el arrepentimiento?
Because when Adam,
cuando Adam
sinned in the beginning,
pecó al inicio,
there was no way to redeem you and I.
No hubo manera de redimirnos.
We were born to fail.
Nacimos para fallar.
We were born to die.
Y para morir.
Because of the curse that God gave Adam.
Por causa de la maldición que le dio a Adam.
2,000 years ago,
hace 2,000 años,
came a man named Jesus.
Vino un hombre llamado Jesús.
And he understood his assignment.
Y entendió su asignación.
He came.
Vino.
He preached about himself and about God to the whole world.
Predicó acerca de él y de Dios a todo el mundo.
And he redeemed us.
Y él nos redimió.
From what the Bible calls the slavery of sin.
De lo que la palabra habla de ser esclavo al pecado.
Give it to the Lord.
Dáselo al Señor.
I need you guys to understand repentance is a gift.
Necesito que entiendan el arrepentimiento es un regalo.
Tell your neighbor repentance is a gift.
Dile a tu vecino arrepentimiento es un regalo.
Ask them, did you actually believe that or did you just repeat what he said?
¿Lo repetiste nomás o lo crees?
There's only one goal with repentance.
Solo hay una meta con arrepentirse.
And I'm going to make it as simple as possible.
Y va a ser lo más sencillo posible.
There's one goal with repentance.
Hay una meta.
It's to reach Jesus.
Es alcanzar a Jesús.
Come on, give it up to him.
Désele
un aplauso. That's not for me, it's for him.
No es para mí, es para él.
Why is that so important?
¿Por qué es tan importante?
There's only one goal with repentance.
Solo hay una meta con arrepentirse.
It's to reach Jesus.
Es alcanzar a Jesús.
Why do we need to repent, Ronald? I'm going to get into that now.
¿Por qué nos tenemos que arrepentir? Ya voy a llegar a eso.
Why do we need to reach Jesus?
¿Por qué tenemos que llegar a Jesús?
Oh my God, yes, I know. I've been hearing about Jesus since I was born.
Ah, yo escucho de Jesús desde que nací.
Ronald, I grew up in the church. I get it.
Ronald, yo lo entiendo. Yo crecí en la iglesia.
I get it.
Lo entiendo.
It's to reach Jesus.
Es para alcanzar a Jesús.
If you really know and understood and heard all those messages and heard the Bible way back when.
Si sabes y entendías ese mensaje hace tiempo.
If you really actually heard those messages, because maybe some of y'all didn't, because growing up I kind of heard half of the messages and I kind of didn't.
Si realmente lo escuchaste porque cuando yo era menor a veces lo escuchaba.
I see some of y'all laughing. How many of you can say amen to that?
¿Cuántos pueden decir amén a eso?
You don't remember like 90% of them.
No se acuerda 90% del mensaje.
But if there's one thing to pull from that,
pero si hay una cosa a sacar de eso,
is that you need to reach Jesus.
Es que tienes que alcanzar a Jesús.
I want you to say with me, reach Jesus.
Dile alcanzar a Jesús.
Why? Because throughout the whole word,
porque a través de la palabra,
throughout the whole Bible,
de toda la Biblia,
it talks about understanding the dependency and the value that Jesus holds.
Habla de entender cuánto tenemos que depender de Dios.
So if you understand that,
si sabes eso,
and you go through the entire word,
y vas por toda la palabra,
you understand there's no life without him.
Sabes que no hay vida sin él.
There's no destination.
No hay destino.
There's nowhere to go.
No hay lugar donde ir.
There's no joy, there's no life.
No hay gozo ni vida.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén a eso?
And when it comes to Jesus,
y cuando viene acerca de Jesús,
he literally tells his disciples, he tells them straight up.
Él le dice a sus discípulos,
he says, anyone who chooses to save their life
dice,
will lose it.
Salvar su vida lo pierde.
But anyone who wishes to lose their life for my sake,
pero aquel que pierde su vida por mí,
shall be saved.
Será salvo.
Can I hear an amen?
¿Puedo escuchar un amen?
Come on, I'm going to need y'all's response here.
Necesito que respondan.
So why is there only one goal with repentance?
Porque solo hay una meta con arrepentirse.
To reach Jesus.
Alcanzar a Jesús.
Because there's no life without him.
Porque no hay vida sin él.
Repentance is the road and the destination is Jesus.
El arrepentimiento es el camino y el destino es Jesús.
There is no other goal.
No hay ninguna otra meta.
There is no other dream.
No hay otro sueño.
It's only him.
Solo es él.
Ronald, how can you say that?
Ronald, ¿cómo dices
eso? You're going to say we're going to throw our life away?
¿Vamos a echar nuestra vida?
Are you saying I'm never going to open up my business?
¿Nunca abro mi negocio?
Are you saying I'm never going to do my career?
¿Nunca voy a hacer mi carrera?
Become a lawyer?
¿Ser abogado?
Become an engineer?
¿Ser ingeniero?
And become a professional athlete?
¿O hacer un atleta?
No.
No.
Matthew 6:33 says, seek first the kingdom of heaven and all things shall be added.
Mateo 6:33 dice, busca primero el reino de Dios y todo será añadido.
So if you can understand,
si pueden entender,
putting him first,
ponlo el primero.
All things shall be added to you.
Todo será añadido.
But there's only one road.
Solo hay un camino.
To him.
A él.
And on that road.
Y en ese camino.
Is repentance.
Es el arrepentimiento.
Ronald, do I just say, Lord, I repent every day and that's it? I'm good?
Ronald, yo digo, Señor, me arrepiento todos los días.
No,
¿está bien?
It's a process.
No es un proceso.
Tell your neighbor, process.
Dile a tu vecino, proceso.
Let's go to John chapter 14, verse 6.
Vamos a Juan 14, 6.
Why is this so important?
¿Por qué es tan importante?
Repentance is the road and destination is Jesus.
Arrepentimiento es el
There's
camino
only
Jesús.
One goal, it's only him.
So hay una meta y él.
John chapter 14 verse 6 says, Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life, and no one comes to me but only through the Father.
Jesús le dijo, yo soy el camino y la verdad y la vida. Nadie viene al Padre sino por mí.
I want all the leaders to raise their hands.
Quiero que todos los líderes
Every
levanten
single
mano.
Leader in this room.
Todos los líderes aquí.
How much more real has this become all these years later than it was the first day that you met God?
¿Qué más real se ha hecho esto para ti hoy en día que el primer día que conociste a Dios?
This has to become more real.
Se tiene que ser más real.
It can't just be, oh, okay, you know, I know that, yeah, amen.
No puede ser, yo lo sé, así, amén.
Why does it have to become more real?
¿Por qué tiene que ser más real?
Because it needs to become a lifestyle.
Porque tiene que ser un estilo de vida.
Not, Jesus is not a part of your life. He should be your life.
Jesús no es parte de tu vida, sino eres tu vida.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén a eso?
And why repentance? Why is repentance the road? I'm not understanding still.
¿Por qué el arrepentimiento es el camino? No lo entiendo.
Repentance is the road and the destination is Jesus.
Y el destino es Jesús.
It's because repentance is the only way to get access back into his presence or to get into his presence.
Es porque el arrepentimiento es la única manera de regresar a su presencia o entrar a su presencia.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén a eso?
So how do we need how do we know we need repentance? Ask your neighbor, how do I know I need repentance?
Dile a tu vecino, ¿cómo sé que tengo que recibir arrepentimiento?
And this is where it gets good.
Y aquí se pone bueno.
I love teaching the gospel this way.
Me fascina enseñar el evangelio de esta
because
manera.
Because it applies to the leader.
Porque aplica al líder.
It applies to me.
Aplica a mí.
It applies to you.
Te aplica a
it
ti.
Applies to the first person that pulled up.
Le aplica al primero
it
que
applies
llegó.
To our spiritual father.
A nuestro padre espiritual.
It applies to the pastor in the other country.
Al pastor en otro país.
It applies to everyone.
Aplica a todos.
Because there's never knowing enough and having enough of Jesus.
Porque nunca hay tanto saber de Jesús ni tener
and
tanto de él.
And if you think that's not the case,
si crees que eso no es el caso,
I might ask you, how much do you know God?
Quizás se pregunte, ¿cuánto conoces a Dios?
Because Paul,
porque Pablo,
who wrote 14 books of the Bible,
que escribió 14 libros de la palabra.
Imagine if one of us wrote the books of the Bible.
Imagínate si nosotros lo escribíamos.
That's crazy to think about.
Es una locura, ¿verdad?
Paul, who wrote 14 books of the Bible,
Pablo que escribió 14.
In his death letter,
en su letra de muerte,
he said that I may know him.
Dijo que yo lo conozca.
Wrote 14 books of the Bible, and he still said, "I still got some knowing to do."
Que escribió 14 libros, yo tengo que conocer más de él.
So if that's him,
si este es él,
how much more us?
¿Cuánto más nosotros?
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén a eso?
Repentance gets us back into his presence.
El arrepentimiento nos lleva a su presencia otra vez.
So how do we know we need repentance?
¿Cómo sabemos que necesitamos arrepentirnos?
And this here, I'm talking to all the kids that grew up in church.
Y esto le hablo a todos los muchachos que crecieron en la iglesia.
I'm talking to the PKs.
A los hijos de pastores.
I'm talking to all the kids that used to sleep in the back because I was one of them too.
A los que dormían atrás en los servicios.
I'm talking to all the leaders.
A todos los líderes.
I'm talking to all the ex-leaders.
A todos los líderes anteriores.
I'm talking to everybody.
Le hablo a todos.
How do we know we need repentance?
¿Cómo sabemos que necesitamos arrepentirnos?
How?
¿Cómo?
How do we figure that out? That's the million-dollar question.
¿Cómo me doy cuenta? Es la pregunta.
Can you rely on your own convictions?
¿Puedes depender de tu propia convicción?
That is the first question you should be asking yourself.
Es la primera pregunta que se debe hacer.
Should you rely on your own convictions?
Debes depender en tu propia convicción.
I don't care if you're an apostle or a prophet.
No me importa si eres apóstol o profeta.
I'll tell all my dad's friends. I don't care who they are.
No me importa, digo a todos los amigos de mi papá.
Do you rely on your own convictions?
Tú dependes de tu propia convicción.
I don't care if they're bishop, archbishop of the, I don't know.
No me importa si es obispo o gran obispo.
Can you rely on your own convictions?
¿Puedes depender de tu propia convicción?
Absolutely not.
Claro que no.
Absolutely not.
Claro que no.
And that is where the enemy gets us.
Y ahí es que nos toma el enemigo.
That's where he lives.
Ahí él vive.
He has a field day.
Y se disfruta.
Because you start creating your own world.
Porque creas tu propio mundo.
Your own values.
Tus propios valores.
Your own system.
Tu propio sistema.
And that's actually anti-God.
Y eso es anti-Dios.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amen a eso?
I know I'm cutting now. I'm cutting deep, but
yo sé que corto profundo.
How do we know we need repentance?
¿Cómo sabemos que necesitamos arrepentirnos?
Can you rely on your own convictions?
¿Puedes depender de tu propia convicción?
No.
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 Now I'm going to prove it to you why not.
Se lo voy a comprobar.
Because number one,
porque número uno,
in order for you to understand,
para que entiendas,
and I wouldn't even say number one because I don't want to confuse y'all.
Ni digo número uno porque no lo quiero confundir.
But can you rely on your own convictions?
Pero puedes con tu propia convicción.
No, you need to rely on the Holy Spirit.
Tienes que confiar en el Espíritu Santo.
Who is the Holy Spirit?
¿Quién es el Espíritu
the
Santo?
Holy Spirit is part of the Holy Trinity of God.
Él es parte de la Trinidad de Dios.
The Bible says God is three in one and one in three.
Dice que él es tres en uno y uno en tres.
It's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
El Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo.
I want all of y'all to say it out loud. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Digan Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo.
It's funny how in the beginning of the message I was talking about Jesus. The only way to the Father is Jesus.
La única manera de ir al Padre es Jesús.
And the only way to Jesus is repentance.
Y para llegar a Jesús es arrepentirse.
And how do you reach repentance?
¿Y cómo llegas a arrepentimiento?
Through the Holy Spirit.
A través del Espíritu Santo.
Come on, give it up to the Lord.
Dale un aplauso al Señor.
And where does the Holy Spirit come from, Ronald?
¿Y de dónde viene el Espíritu
He's
Santo?
All over
Ronald.
The Scripture.
En toda la Escritura.
But he arrived on the scene in replacement of.
Pero él llegó a la escena reemplazando a.
And I don't even want to say replacement, but he came in the stead of Jesus.
Y él vino en el puesto de Jesús, ni reemplazar.
Let's go to John chapter 16, verse 7.
Vamos a Juan 16, 7.
But I tell you the truth, it is to your advantage that I go away.
Pero yo os les digo la verdad, os conviene que yo me vaya.
Before I start reading, I'm going to give a little bit of context to this verse.
Le doy un contexto un poquito antes de leerlo.
Jesus gathered all the disciples.
Jesús reunió los discípulos.
And he goes, look, I'm going to die.
Dijo, yo me voy a morir.
And everybody's like, oh my God. It's like that episode in SpongeBob.
Es como SpongeBob.
When they're all running, all the SpongeBobs are running in his head like, and everything's on fire.
Que todos corren en su cabeza y están en
the
fuego.
The Bible actually says before this, it says that they were all really sad. All the disciples were like, what are you saying? What are you talking about? What's happening?
Antes de esto decía la palabra que todos estaban asustados, estaban tristes, diciendo, ¿por qué hablas de esto?
And he calms them down.
Y él los calma.
There's nothing to worry about.
Yo, no hay nada a preocuparse.
This is before he died.
Esto antes
before
de morirse,
he went to the cross.
Antes de ir a la cruz,
before he understood
antes que entendí,
what he needed to do.
Lo que tenía que hacer.
But I tell you the truth, it is to your advantage that I go away.
Pero yo os digo la verdad, os conviene que yo me vaya.
For I do, if I do not go away, the helper,
porque si no me fuera el consolador,
will not come to you.
No vendría a vosotros.
But if I go, meaning if I do leave, if I do go,
mas si yo me voy, si yo me voy,
I will send him the Holy Spirit to you.
Yo les enviaré él, el Espíritu Santo,
to be in close fellowship with you.
Para que esté en compañerismo cercano con ustedes.
Come on, give it up to the Lord.
Dale un aplauso al Señor.
And I would love for y'all to keep responding.
quisiera que sigan respondiendo.
How do I know?
Como yo sé.
Because you're telling God, whenever you clap, that's a way of saying amen.
Cuando aplauden es una manera de decir amén.
And I didn't know this up until like a few years ago.
No lo sabía como hace unos años.
But amen means yes, I agree.
Amén significa sí,
estoy de acuerdo. If you didn't know that, now you know.
Si no lo sabías, ahora lo sabes.
So if you agree with anything I'm speaking, I would love for you to respond.
Si estás de acuerdo, quisiera que respondan.
And clap and say amen. That's amazing.
Y aplaudan y digan amén, eso está bueno.
I'm not asking for cheerleaders.
No pido que sean
cheerleaders. But I'm asking you to agree with the word if you really believe it.
Les pido que estén de acuerdo con la palabra si lo creen realmente.
All right now. Somebody said it. So when it comes to understanding, how do we know we need to repent? The Holy Spirit.
¿Cómo sabemos que tenemos que arrepentirnos? El Espíritu
Santo. The Bible says he is our helper, our comforter, our advocate, our intercessor, our counselor, strengthener, and our standby.
Que él es nuestro ayudador, el que nos da confort, los que nos apoya, ora por nosotros, nos da consejo, nos fortalece y está ahí en nuestro lado.
Look at all those ways that the Bible describes the Holy Spirit.
Mira todas las maneras que la Biblia describe al Espíritu Santo.
So if you haven't been comforted,
si no has estado cómodo,
there's an answer.
Hay una respuesta.
If you need an advocate for you,
si necesitas alguien que te respalde,
there's an answer.
Hay una respuesta.
If you need an intercessor for you,
necesitas un intercesor,
there's an answer.
Hay una respuesta.
If you need a counselor,
necesitas consejero,
someone to tell you where to go,
para que te guíe,
obviously not where to go to the bathroom or where to sleep, but where to go in life,
no para ir al baño, pero sino a dónde ir en la vida,
what direction to take,
qué paso tomar,
there's an answer.
Hay una respuesta.
If there's someone to, I love the last part that says stand by.
Aquel que está ahí en espera.
Stand by, I promise you, it's not super deep. It's just to stand right next to you. Stand by, I'm standing right by him.
Es simplemente estar ahí al lado tuyo.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén?
The Holy Spirit was designed for all those things.
El Espíritu Santo fue diseñado para todas esas cosas.
That's how the Bible says that he's the breath of God.
La palabra dice que él es el aliento de Dios.
That he's the Spirit of God.
Él es el Espíritu de Dios.
And Jesus says, I sent him.
Jesús dice, yo lo envié.
I will send him when I go.
Yo lo enviaré cuando yo me vaya.
Because it's better because he should be here with you.
Porque él debe estar aquí contigo.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén a eso?
So what role does the Holy Spirit play when it comes to repentance?
¿Qué función toma el Espíritu Santo acerca del arrepentimiento?
I want us to go to John chapter 16 verse 8.
Vamos a Juan 16, 8.
So now we know we can't rely on our own convictions.
Ya sabemos que no podemos depender de nuestra propia convicción.
Why? Because our convictions are a mix of things that came from us.
Nuestra convicción es parte que viene mezclada de nosotros,
from our parents,
de nuestros padres,
from our friends,
nuestras amistades.
Are any of those things bad? No.
¿Algunas de esas cosas son malas? No.
But they're not going to help it. They're not going to help it either.
Pero no van a ayudar tampoco.
The only guide, the only way to really deal with those convictions,
la única manera de lidiar con esas
convicciones, and to instill the correct convictions in your life,
y meterte las convicciones correctas,
is through the Holy Spirit.
Es a través del Espíritu
so
Santo.
The verse we just read, look at what the verse right after says.
Mira lo que dice el versículo siguiente.
And I want everyone to read this with me, all right?
Todos leanlo conmigo.
Ready? 1, 2, 3. And he, when he comes, will convict the world about the guilt of sin and the need for Savior. And about righteousness and about judgment. Oh, okay.
Ah, okay.
So first Jesus says, hey, this is what he's going to help you with.
Primero dice, con esto te va a ayudar.
But then it tells us the Holy Spirit convicts us of sin.
Y dice, el Espíritu Santo nos trae convicción de pecado.
And all the Bible says that all men have fallen short of the glory of God.
Dice, todo hombre ha caído corto de la
and
gloria
even
de Dios.
If you are saved,
y aun si eres
the
salvo,
Bible still says that there's a race,
la palabra dice, hay una carrera
of salvation,
de salvación.
And it says that we still need to walk our faith out.
Y dice que tenemos que caminar nuestra
and it
fe.
Still says that we need to, in order to please God, that we need to have faith to please God.
Y tenemos necesitamos fe para complacer a Dios.
And the Bible says that we need to flee from temptation.
Y huir de la tentación.
So where am I going with this?
Entonces, ¿a dónde voy con esto?
That the moment you get saved, it doesn't get easier. If anything, it gets harder.
Que el momento que eres salvo no se hace más fácil.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén a esto?
So how do I figure out what's how do I figure out right from wrong?
Entonces, ¿cómo me doy cuenta del bien y el mal?
Do I debate it with my homeboy?
Ahí tengo un debate con mis
that
amigos.
That I went to private school with.
Que fue a la escuela privada con.
Do I debate it with my parents?
O con mis padres.
Do I debate it with my pastor?
O con mi pastor.
Do I debate it with you, Ronald?
O contigo, Ronald?
No.
No.
You take it to one person.
Y vas a una persona.
And that person's name is the Holy Spirit.
Y el nombre es el Espíritu Santo.
Can I hear an amen to that?
Puedo escuchar un amén a eso.
Can I hear an amen? I need a stronger hand clap.
Necesito un más fuerte aplauso de ustedes.
The Holy Spirit is the one that convicts us of sin.
El Espíritu Santo trae convicción de pecado.
Ronald, are you telling me that the Holy Spirit just calls everything bad out in our life?
Él llama todo lo malo en nuestra vida?
No.
No.
There's many, many things that he does in our life.
Hay muchas cosas que él hace.
I just gave you a whole list of things that he does.
Les di una lista de cosas que él
hace.
But
one other thing that he does is convicts us of sin.
Pero él también nos trae convicción de pecado.
Tell your neighbor, conviction.
Di convicción.
So now let's define what conviction is.
Vamos a definir qué es convicción.
Conviction means to admit the truth about your decision, whether you're wrong or you're right.
Significa decir la verdad de tu decisión, sea correcto o incorrecto.
I know there's very few married people in here, but you guys are like, all the girls are like,
Hay mucho, muy poco casados,
or even,
las esposas
even
ahí,
if you're in a relationship too,
o una relación también.
And you know you're right about that friend.
Que sabes tienes una razón de ese amigo.
Your man's friend, you're just like, I just smell, you know,
ese tengo los
nothing good there.
Que no hay nada bueno ahí.
Might even be marijuana. I don't know. I don't smell anything good there.
Marihuana, pero no escucho, no siento nada bueno.
It means to admit the truth about your decision.
Significa decir la verdad de tu decisión.
So we've all made really bad decisions.
Todos hemos tomado decisiones malas.
I want everybody, if you're listening to me, I want you to answer me honestly, because the Holy Spirit is watching you.
Si me
now
escuchan,
you know who he is, and now you know what he does, now you know he's watching you.
Si me escuchan, sea honesto, que el Espíritu Santo escucha.
How many of you have made really bad decisions? I want to raise the hands. I would, if I can raise all my limbs, I would, and just float in the air.
Levante su mano si tomado malas decisiones. Si fuera
everybody
mí,
here, you know you've made bad decisions.
Que han tomado malas decisiones.
In anything.
En cualquier cosa.
And you're just like, dang. And then the worst part, you just like play back in your head. You're like, if I would have just like, you know, if I would have just done this or that.
Y lo peor es que piensas después, ay, si hubiese hecho lo otro, si hubiera
I wouldn't have gotten into that accident. I wouldn't have, you know, got into this issue.
No hubiese estado en ese problema ni en este accidente.
But guess what?
Pero ¿sabes qué?
The Holy Spirit is so amazing.
El Espíritu Santo es tan increíble.
He's still with you. He stands by you.
Y sigue contigo.
And he still nudges you and says, "Hey, don't do that."
Y te toca y dice, "No hagas
hey,
eso."
I'm still here.
Sigo aquí.
Hey, I'm still here.
Yo sigo aquí.
I'm still supporting you.
Te sigo apoyando.
But if you allow those convictions to just go, you don't. It's crazy because the moment you lose. The moment you start ignoring those convictions, not from you.
El momento que empiezas a ignorar esas convicciones, no las tuyas.
The convictions that you know you did something wrong.
Las convicciones que tú sabes que hiciste mal.
The moment you start ignoring them,
el momento que lo empiezas a ignorar,
you start losing the fear of the Lord.
Empiezas a perder el temor de Dios.
And then that's when you start becoming numb to bad decisions.
Y ahí te duermes a las malas decisiones.
And when you start becoming numb to bad decisions,
y cuando te haces el dormido a las malas
when
decisiones,
you lose the fear of the Lord,
pierdes el temor de Dios,
bad things seem good and good things seem bad.
Lo malo se ve bueno y lo bueno se ve malo.
And it's a snowball effect.
Y es un efecto de nieve.
And you reach a point,
y llegas a un punto,
where you have no limits.
Que ya no tienes límites.
And then things that happen in our world, you have no idea how you got there in the beginning.
Y de la cosa que sucede, ya no sabes cómo llegaste a ese punto.
And finally you wake up and you're like, whoa, how did I get here?
Y un día te despiertas y dices, ay, ¿cómo llegué aquí?
It all started when you ignored your convictions.
Empezó cuando ignoraste tu convicción.
Listen to what the Holy Spirit is telling you.
Escucha lo que el Espíritu
Listen
Santo
to
te
that
dice.
Nudge that the Holy Spirit is giving you.
Escucha ese toque que Él te da.
You want to know why?
¿Sabes por qué?
I love the Holy Spirit.
Porque yo amo al Espíritu Santo.
And I love that the Bible says that it's the Holy Trinity.
Y yo amo que dice la Trinidad Santa.
It's because the Bible identifies him as a person.
Lo identifica como una persona.
That means
significa
that if you receive Jesus,
que si recibes a
and
Jesús,
you receive the Holy Spirit,
y recibes el Espíritu Santo,
whatever you do, whether right or wrong, he's there. He's right there next to you.
Lo que tú hagas, lo correcto o incorrecto, está ahí al lado tuyo.
Stand by.
Está ahí en espera.
The problem is, do you feel him or not?
Pero lo sientes o no.
Why? Are you following those convictions or not?
¿Por qué sigue sus convicciones o no?
Am I talking to somebody tonight?
Estoy hablando a alguien en esta noche.
And this is not for, you know, the new believer that just pulled up.
Y no es para el nuevo creyente que llegó.
Just walked in here. This is for everyone.
Es para todos.
This is for you. This is for me.
Es para ti. Es para mí.
For everyone.
Es para todos.
Why? Because we are tested every single day, guys.
¿Por qué? Somos probados diariamente.
We are tested every single day. Our minds, our hearts,
nuestras mentes, nuestros corazones,
our bodies. We're tested with sin every single day.
Nuestros cuerpos probados diariamente.
Our eyes, our ears. We're tested every single day.
Nuestros ojos, oídos, diariamente.
The Holy Spirit convicts us of sin.
El Espíritu Santo trae convicción de pecado.
Number two.
Número dos.
And I love that. If we can go back to verse 7.
Si regresamos al versículo 7.
Sorry, verse 8.
Versículo
8. So first he convicts.
Primero trae convicción.
But the second thing that the Holy Spirit does.
Pero lo segundo que él hace.
He convicts the world about the guilt of sin and the need for a savior and about righteousness.
Convencerá al mundo de pecado, de justicia y de juicio.
And I guarantee you 90% of the people in this room.
Le aseguro 90% de la gente aquí.
Haven't reached this level with the Holy Spirit.
No ha llegado a este punto con el Espíritu Santo.
Why? Because you've always ignored your convictions.
Porque siempre has ignorado tu convicción.
So now there's a second area.
Hay una segunda área.
Now about righteousness.
Ahora de justicia.
So now, not only, okay, now you've been a goody two shoes. You've been with the Lord, and you're like, God, thank you so much. I've been good.
Ahora
I haven't sinned. Yes, praise Jesus.
Ahora estado bien con el Señor, no has pecado. Dices, ay, sí. Alabado sea Dios,
I'm
no
on
pecado.
A good run.
Estoy en una buena carrera.
It's been a week. Let's go.
Hace una semana, vamos.
It's been 24 hours. Listen, I've been there.
Yo he estado ahí.
You gotta. You have to celebrate those small victories.
Tienes que celebrar las pequeñas victorias.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén a eso?
And I gotta hurry.
Tengo que correr.
The second part.
La segunda parte.
Of convictions.
De convicciones.
Conviction is not only. That's why I said. It means to admit the truth. Conviction means to admit the truth about your decision, whether you're right or you're wrong.
Significa decir la verdad de tu decisión, sea correcto o incorrecto.
So he convicts you of sin if you're wrong.
Él te da convicción de pecado si lo hiciste mal.
Or he convicts you of righteousness means you know what to do. You know what the right thing is to do.
O te da convicción de justicia porque sabes lo correcto de hacer.
In other words,
en otras palabras,
righteousness.
Justicia.
Tell your neighbor, righteousness.
Digan justicia.
And if you have a friend next to you, I want you to get up close to their ear and be like, righteousness.
Si tienes un vecino, acércate al oído y diga,
justicia. Don't get weird, please.
No sean raro.
I know some people got weird. That's why they
yo sé que algunos son raros y pueden así.
Holy Spirit brings persuasion of righteousness.
Espíritu Santo te convence de ser justo.
After you repent totally under the conviction of the Holy Spirit,
después arrepentirte completamente bajo la convicción del Espíritu Santo,
now you're what I said, that 24 hours or that week or that month or that year run that you've been on.
Eso 24 horas, una semana, dos meses que he estado
bien.
You're
like, man, I'm doing good.
Ay, me va bien.
There's another level.
Hay otro nivel.
Which is now a persuasion of righteousness.
Que ahora es para caminar en ser justo.
I need to do what's right.
Lo tengo que hacer lo correcto.
I need to do what's right.
Necesito hacer lo correcto.
I need to do what's right.
Necesito hacer lo correcto.
Tell your neighbor, I need to do what's right.
Y tu vecino, necesito hacer lo correcto.
How do we know what to do what's right?
¿Cómo sabemos hacer lo correcto?
The Holy Spirit leads us.
El Espíritu Santo nos guía.
I said the Holy Spirit leads us.
El Espíritu Santo nos guía.
And the Holy Spirit convicts when we're wrong about something.
Y el Espíritu Santo da convicción cuando estamos mal de algo.
But he persuades us when we're right.
Pero nos persuade cuando estamos correcto.
That's why he told Abraham. The Bible says that the Spirit of God persuaded Abraham.
Por eso dice el Espíritu de Dios le empujó a Abraham.
And to understand the power of repentance.
Para entender el poder de arrepentimiento.
The reason why repentance is a gift.
¿Por qué la razón que es un regalo?
It because it removes something from you.
Es porque remueve algo de ti.
Which is what?
¿Qué es qué?
Sin.
Pecado.
And to understand what sin is.
Y para saber qué es pecado.
Tell your neighbor, do you know what sin is?
Dile a tu vecino, ¿sabes qué es el pecado?
Sin is nothing more than the rebellion against the authority of God.
No es nada menos de rebelión contra la autoridad de Dios.
That sounds strong, Ronald.
Suena fuerte, Ronald.
That sounds like a AGM quote.
Suena como algo que dice AGM.
Rebellion against the authority of God.
Ser rebelde contra la autoridad de Dios.
Why?
¿Por qué?
Because if you notice,
porque si te das cuenta,
maybe not all your convictions are aligned to the Bible.
Quizás no todas tus convicciones están de acuerdo
a la Biblia.
But some
of them are because your parents instilled them in you.
Pero algunas quizás porque tus padres te enseñó.
So then you already kind of know what's right and wrong.
Entonces ya sabes un poco de qué es bien y qué es mal.
And why rebellion against the authority of God? What does that mean?
¿Y por qué rebelión en contra la autoridad de Dios?
The authority of God is the word of God.
La autoridad de Dios es la palabra de Dios.
The Bible says, "Do not murder."
Dices, no mates.
Do not lie.
No mientas.
Do not fornicate.
No forniques.
Do not. And there's a whole list.
No hagas, y hay una lista.
That is the authority of God.
Esa es la autoridad
telling
de
him,
Dios.
Hey, you shouldn't do these things.
Te dicen, no debes hacer lo siguiente.
And you shouldn't do these things outside of marriage.
Ni hacer estas cosas fuera matrimonio.
Or you shouldn't do these things at all.
Ni hacer estas cosas para nada.
It all comes from the word of God.
Todo viene de la palabra de Dios.
So what? Why is repentance a gift? It removes something.
Porque es un regalo, remueve algo.
It removes sin from our life.
Remueve el pecado de nuestra vida.
So, if the Bible says don't lie,
si la palabra dice no mientas,
if you're lying,
si mientes,
you're rebelling against the word of God.
Estás rebelde de la palabra de Dios.
If the Bible says don't steal,
si dice no robes,
and you're in class and you see that number two pencil, that mechanical one that's like $70, you're just like, dang, I need that.
Y ves ese lápiz $30 en la clase y dices, ay, lo necesito.
And you just swipe it.
Y te lo llevas.
The Bible says, do not steal.
La palabra dice,
that
no
ain't yours.
Robes.
Did you pay for it?
No es tuyo, tú lo pagaste.
Can I hear an amen to that?
¿Puedo escuchar un amén a eso?
I'm making it very simple so you guys could understand it.
Se lo hago bien sencillo para que lo entiendan.
So what do you do when convictions come?
Entonces, ¿qué hacen cuando viene la convicción? Tengo que terminar.
If you feel, if you, you, first of all, you need to allow the Holy Spirit.
Primero, permite al Espíritu Santo.
Second, you need to yield to those convictions.
Segundo, rendirte a aquellas convicciones.
Say with me, yield to those convictions.
Y rendir a esas convicciones.
Say with me, yield to those convictions.
Y rendir a esas convicciones.
So if you're in the car,
entonces, si estás en el carro,
tomorrow night,
mañana por la noche,
Ron, I got a date.
Ay, tengo una cita.
She's beautiful, Ron.
Ella es bella, Ron.
Or Ron, I got a brand new job.
Pero tengo un trabajo nuevo.
Or whatever, Ron, I got a date.
O tengo una cita.
Let's stick with the date.
Vamos a seguir con la cita.
She's beautiful.
Es bella.
And y'all are together, and you guys vibe. You guys have a great time.
Y pasan un buen tiempo.
You're just like, wow.
Wow.
Your eyes become the movie lens where everything just becomes blurry, and just like, wow, spotlight, boom.
Tu ojo la luz sobre ella, todo es perfecto.
Everything the it's set.
Todo está hecho.
Wow. It's only the first date, but wow.
La primera cita, pero
wow. I don't want to fall in love, but wow.
No me quiero enamorar, pero wow.
The moment you guys leave, you picked her up, you know, you're nice and shaved.
La recogiste,
you actually put on some deo, you put on some cologne.
Te puse colonia de osarante.
You wear your best fit.
Te pones la mejor ropa.
You're like, yes, it still fits. Let's go.
Sí, todavía me queda. Vamos.
And you're driving her, and then you talk to her, and her voice is like, you know, like, I don't even know.
Su voz está bien, yo ni sé.
I don't even know how to explain it.
Ni sé cómo aplicarlo.
Sounded like a river, Ron. You don't understand.
Suena como un río.
How do I get so specific? Because I hear these stories from these people.
¿Cómo soy tan específico? Yo escucho estas cosas de la gente.
Where am I going with this?
¿A dónde voy?
No, you know, and we stayed there talking all night. They asked us to get up because they were closing because of how long we talked.
Nos quedamos hablando toda la noche, que nos vayamos.
Stayed up all night talking.
Nos quedamos hablando toda la noche.
But then it gets to a point.
Pero llega un punto.
That y'all get in the car.
Se van al carro.
You play that, you know, The Weeknd or Ray J. Don't think I don't know.
Pones ahí esa musiquita.
You play, oh, it's perfect. You're just like, put on your little, I don't know if any of you guys do that, but you put on your, what is it called? Chapstick.
Te pones ahí el chapstick.
You're like, and you're just driving, you look at her, and you're like,
va manejando,
you want to make sure
viendo
the lighting's good. And everything is going as planned.
Y todo va como planeaste.
And then all of a sudden,
y de repente,
she's just like, oh my God, this was such a great night. Yo,
ay, fue tan buena noche.
And then you blast the music more, so you're like, shh, just listen to this, you know.
Vibe, you know? Música y quédate tranquila.
And then you just get to a point
llegas a un punto
where you're just infatuated.
Que estás tan enamorado.
You're just like, yes. But then you get to her house.
Pero llegas a su casa.
Oh my God, my parents are not home yet.
Ay, mi padre no ha llegado a casa.
And then you just get that, like, you know, that, like, you get, what is it called? Calofrío.
You get those chills.
Goosebumps, because you're just like, oh, I don't know what to do.
Ay, no sé qué hacer.
And you're just like, man, she looks so good tonight.
Ay, se ve tan buena esta noche.
Dang, I don't know.
No sé.
And all of a sudden, you get that feeling.
Y de repente,
get your butt out of there.
Huye de ese lugar.
Yeah, that's what you would think.
Eso es lo que tú piensas.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh,
sí,
yeah.
Sí, sí, claro, woo, sí.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. That's not what you're thinking at the time.
Eso es lo que no piensas eso en el momento.
And the Holy Spirit says, hey.
El Espíritu Santo dice,
hey,
oye,
what are you doing?
¿Qué haces?
Get out of there.
Vete.
The Bible says, flee from sexual temptation.
La palabra dice, huye de la tentación.
If the Bible is saying it, it's because the Bible is saying you, repeat it with me, you cannot handle it. One more time.
Dilo,
you
si la palabra lo dice,
cannot handle it.
La palabra dice, tú no puedes lidiar con eso.
Can I hear an amen, somebody?
¿Puedo escuchar un amen a alguien?
And somehow we're like, nah,
dice,
I got this.
Nah, yo lo tengo,
this.
Yo lo tengo. Estoy
I
bien.
Got all the strength in the world.
Tengo toda la fuerza del mundo, vamos.
And at the end of the day,
y al fin del
you end
día,
up doing stuff you weren't supposed to.
Haces lo que no tenías
you
que
were
hacer.
Going to church.
Ibas a la iglesia.
You were serving God.
Le servías a Dios.
You were doing everything you needed to.
Hacías todo lo que tenías que
and
hacer.
Because of that one amazing night,
y por esa una noche,
you completely removed.
Te removiste por completo.
You start losing your conviction.
Pierdes tus convicciones.
You start getting away from God.
Te alejas de Dios.
You stop doing what you used to do.
Paras de hacer lo que hacías antes.
And before you know it,
y de repente,
before you know it,
antes que te das cuenta,
Ron. I see the guy like 6 months, 9 months later, Ron. Bro, I made a huge mistake. What happened?
Cometí un gran error.
Remember that night I told you about?
¿Te acuerdas de esa noche?
Man,
ay,
I'm sorry.
Perdóname.
And the Holy Spirit was there the whole time. I told you so.
Y el Espíritu Santo ahí, oye, te dije.
I told you so.
Te dije.
What is the point with this story?
¿Qué es el punto con esa historia?
You guys need to make sure.
Tienen que tener la certeza
that your convictions align with the Holy Spirit.
Que tu convicción se alinee con el Espíritu Santo. ¿Puedo escuchar un amén a eso?
So I want everyone in this room.
Quiero que todos en ese lugar.
Bow your heads.
Que inclinen su rostro.
Close your eyes.
Cierra sus ojos.
And I want to call the reason why I gave that story.
Y la razón por cual di esa historia.
I really felt from the Holy Spirit to give that story.
Sentí el Espíritu Santo dar esa historia.
Because there's a lot of people here.
Porque hay muchos aquí.
That have felt those convictions.
Que han sentido esas convicciones.
Especially.
Especialmente.
Sexual sin.
Pecado sexual.
And the Holy Spirit was showing me sexual sin.
Y el Espíritu Santo me mostraba pecado sexual.
I don't want your fear or your shame.
No quiero tu vergüenza ni tu temor.
To hold you.
Que te detenga.
From that being a lifestyle.
De eso ser parte de tu estilo de vida.
Whether it's pornography.
Sea pornografía.
Whether it's masturbation.
Sea masturbación.
Whether it is you are having sex outside of marriage.
Sea tú tener sexo fuera de matrimonio.
Whether you're struggling in any sexual area.
Sea que luche en cualquier área sexual.
And I'm going to ask the leaders to come up.
Y le pido a los líderes que vengan.
And I want you, and I want us to lower the lights a little bit.
Quiero que bajemos las luces un poco.
Because I want you guys to have all the trust in the world.
Porque quiero que tengan toda la confianza en el mundo.
If you really, truly,
si verdaderamente,
want change in that area of your life.
Quieres cambio en esa área de tu vida.
If you really,
si quieres,
have said, Ron, I have ignored those convictions.
Has dicho, Ron, yo he ignorado esas convicciones.
Before I call up those people.
Antes de llamar a aquellas personas.
I want every single person.
Quiero que todos.
Every single person to stand up.
Cada persona que se ponga de pie.
Every single person in this room, stand up.
Cada persona póngase de pie.
And I want you to lift up your hands.
Y levante sus manos.
And close your eyes.
Y cierre sus ojos.
And I want you guys to do a prayer with me.
Quiero que oren conmigo.
And this is not for me, guys.
Y esto no es para mí.
This is not for Ronald.
No es para Ronald.
This is not for the person to your right or to your left.
No es para tu vecino.
This is for you.
Es para ti.
God wants you.
Dios quiere que tú
to lean in tonight.
Te acerques en esta noche.
And overcome temptation.
Sobrepase la tentación.
But more than that, overcome sin.
Pero más que todo el pecado.
And follow and hear and be led by the convictions of the Holy Spirit.
Y escucha y sea guiado por la convicción del Espíritu Santo.
I want everyone in this room.
Quiero que todos aquí
to lift your hands.
Que levante sus manos.
Lift both hands. I want everyone in this room, even the leaders, if you guys could just, let's just join in with everyone.
Unémonos con ellos.
I want everyone here to lift both hands.
Que todos levanten sus dos manos.
And close your eyes.
Y cierren sus ojos.
And I want you to just repeat this prayer after me.
Y repitan conmigo.
Say, Father God.
Digan, Padre Celestial.
I want you to say it loud, guys. Father God.
Digan, Padre Celestial.
I pray today.
Yo oro en esta noche.
I know.
Yo sé.
Now I know.
Ahora sé.
That these convictions,
que estas convicciones,
that I have,
que yo tengo,
are not enough,
no son suficientes,
they're not enough,
no son suficientes,
and I ask you tonight, God,
y te pido en esta noche, Señor,
I ask you tonight, God,
te pido en esta noche,
Holy Spirit,
Espíritu Santo,
I give you permission,
te doy permiso,
I give you permission,
te doy permiso,
into my heart,
a mi corazón,
come on, I want you guys to say loud, I give you permission,
te doy permiso.
Into my heart,
a mi corazón,
into my mind,
a mi mente,
into my life once again,
a mi vida otra vez.
Lord, I lay my life down,
Señor, rindo mi vida,
and I pray, God,
y oro,
Holy Spirit,
Espíritu Santo,
descend over me,
desciende sobre mí,
Lord,
Señor,
and bring back the fear of God in my life,
trae el temor de Dios a mi vida otra vez,
and bring back those convictions that I once had,
y trae esas convicciones que tuve un día,
and I ask you, God,
y te pido, Señor,
from this day on,
de hoy en adelante,
I will obey those convictions,
yo voy a obedecer esas convicciones,
I will commit,
me voy a comprometer,
to follow you, Holy Spirit,
a seguirte, Espíritu Santo,
into a lifestyle of repentance,
a un estilo de vida de arrepentimiento.
And I pray today,
y oro hoy,
from here on out,
de hoy adelante,
from here on out,
de hoy adelante,
I will only listen to your convictions.
Solo escucharé tus convicciones.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Hey guys, I hope that message impacted you.
Espero que el mensaje le haya impactado.
I know that it was a blessing to me, and I'm sure it was one to you.
Sabe que ha impactado mi vida y quiero que también impacte la tuya.
Share it with somebody when you get a chance.
Comparte con alguien cuando tengas un momento.
And you know, something important too is don't just listen to this message, but apply it.
No solamente escucha el mensaje, también quiero que lo apliques.
Whatever you learn today, make it a part of your life.
Lo que has aprendido hoy, también hazlo parte de tu vida.
And now I want to take a moment to just speak to anybody that maybe you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior.
Quiero hablarle a esa persona mirando, si tú no conoces a Jesús como tu Salvador.
Maybe you stumbled upon this video and you're like, wow, this really touched me.
Puede ser que te encontraste con este video y dices, man, este video me ha tocado.
And I want to know more about this Jesus that I just heard about.
Quiero saber más de este Jesús que he escuchado.
Then I just want to invite you to do this prayer.
Quiero que hagas esta oración junto con nosotros.
And when you do this prayer, you don't just say it.
Cuando la hagas, no solamente dila.
You have to believe it in your heart.
Créelo con tu corazón.
So as you say these words,
mientras digas estas palabras,
you just believe every single word that you are saying.
Cree cada palabra que estás diciendo.
Because you see, Jesus died for every single one of our sins.
Jesús murió por cada uno de nuestros pecados.
And the Bible teaches us that when man dies, he goes to one of two places.
Y la palabra nos dice, cuando el hombre muere, va a uno de dos lugares.
Either heaven or hell.
El cielo o el infierno.
We're all destined for hell because we are born sinners.
Todos estamos destinados a ir al infierno porque todos somos pecadores.
But God sent his only begotten son Jesus.
Pero Dios mandó a su único hijo Jesús.
To die on a cross for our sins.
Para morir en la cruz por nosotros.
He took up all the sins that we've ever committed.
Él tomó todos nuestros pecados.
And he gave us salvation on a cross.
Y nos dio una salvación en la cruz.
If you want to receive this free gift.
Si quieres este regalo que es gratis.
Of eternal life in heaven.
De vida eterna en el cielo.
Repeat this prayer with me.
Repite conmigo esta oración.
And believe it in your heart.
Y créela con tu corazón.
Say, dear Lord Jesus.
Padre celestial.
I receive you in my heart.
Te recibo en mi corazón.
I receive you as my Lord and Savior.
Como mi Señor y Salvador.
I believe that you were crucified.
Yo creo que fuiste crucificado.
And you also resurrected on the third day.
Y también te levantaste al tercer día.
I receive your salvation.
Recibo tu salvación.
I receive eternal life in heaven.
Y recibo la vida eterna en el cielo.
I know that if I were to die today,
yo sé que si muriera en este día,
I would wake up and be in your arms.
Me voy a levantar en tus brazos.
Thank you.
Gracias.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Amen. If you just made this prayer with us,
si acabas de hacer esta oración,
I just want to say welcome.
Te quiero dar la bienvenida.
You have officially entered into eternal life with Jesus
Christ.
Has
entrado eternamente con Jesús.
You started a walk with your Lord and Savior.
Y comenzaste un caminar con tu Salvador.
And I want to encourage you, don't ever look back.
Te quiero decir que no mires atrás.
Start this relationship with your Heavenly Father and don't ever stop it.
Comienza esta relación con tu Padre Celestial y nunca pares.
Continue to look for Him and seek Him.
Míralo y búscalo.
Read your word and just dive deep into His presence.
Mira la palabra, busca su presencia.
and you will see that your life will change for the better.
Y tu vida cambiará por siempre.
And guys, if this message blessed you,
si este mensaje ha sido de bendición,
we want to give you guys an opportunity.
Te quiero dar la oportunidad
to sow into our ministry.
Para que bendigas el ministerio.
And even more importantly, sow into the kingdom of heaven.
Y para más importante, que bendigas el reino de Dios.
Because as the word teaches us,
como nos dice la palabra de Dios,
man receives it here on earth.
El hombre lo recibe aquí en la tierra.
But God receives it up in
pero
heaven.
El Padre lo recibe en los cielos.
And he blesses a cheerful giver.
Y él bendice al dador alegre.
So whatever that amount is that you want to bless,
cualquiera sea la cantidad que quieras dar,
just put it down there.
Ponla en tu sobre.
You can give online. There's you click the button.
Puede ponerla o en el online.
You can text KJM Miami to 77977.
KJM Miami 77977.
Keyword youth.
Y la palabra aquí será jóvenes.
And you can just give whatever that amount is that the Lord is placing on your
lo
heart.
Que Dios ha puesto en tu corazón, eso da.
And from all of our family here at King Jesus Ministry,
y de la familia Jesús,
we just want to say thank you.
Te queremos dar las gracias.
And we just pray that the Lord blesses every bit of seed that you are
declaramos
giving.
Declaramos que Él bendice cada semilla que has dado.
In Jesus' name
en
we
nombre
pray.
De Jesús, amen.
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 We love you guys.